shit, that wasn't Lil B? Okay.
Everyone's recording.
Thank you, Bass God. 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 Thank you, Bass God.
Table don't fall and everything stays smooth, but first off, NYU, I want to say I love you. So and thank each and every one of you, you know, every beautiful person in the building, every legend, every historical human being, you know, every future legend in the building, man. I'm in the building with a bunch of the future, you know, so y'all gonna be helping me, you know, when things get hard for me, you know. That's what I hope, you know, I hope. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. But, you know, I hope everybody leaves this, you know, and this, like, conversation and this discussion together, because I want everybody to feel like family. And this is not a, you, everybody listen to me, this is everybody's a part of it. Just like how you see everybody's talking, if you feel compelled to say something in your heart, you know, please do. Because at the end of the day, I love y'all. Because at the end of the day, you know, we all have something to teach and we all have something to say. And I want to come to this that really, you know, what I feel like symbolizes everybody that's in the building right now. And this story just happened to me 2 days ago. So I'm at going to the gas station, and it's this older guy at the gas station. You know, he looks like he's about 70, you know, or something like that. And, you know, me, you know, generalizing and stereotyping or whatnot, you know, I asked the dude, and me thinking in my head, but I asked him, I'm like, excuse me, sir, how you doing? I'm like, what has changed for you in the, you know, what have you seen change, like, in the last, you know, years from, like, now, from when you was younger to, like, now? And, you know, he's like, you really want to know?
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, sir, I really want to know. And he was like, you know what's changed? And he was like, your attitude. And that was deep, bro. That was deep. And I feel like that represents all of us in here, you feel me, today. Because I really want to thank y'all, you know, for not judging me, you know, and being able to respect everybody's legendary, you know, just as being a human, you know, and being able to appreciate other people as a human, because that's what we all should be able to do. I specialize in love. I'm here, you know. A lot of people, you know, they wonder, I can't even say a lot, you know, the small majority that don't understand wonder why Lil B would be here. But, you know, but it's good because I love to spread love. You know, that's what I'm here to do, you know. And it's like, if I gotta prove that, you know, and it takes me to come here and speak on that, you know, that's that. But, you know, and I want to come to like this. This is a big thing that I want to speak on and like let everybody know to set the tone. Nobody in this building asked to be born. Like, nobody asked, like, you know, nobody asked to be, you didn't ask to be you, bro. I didn't ask to be me. I didn't ask to have this skin. You feel me? Like, I didn't ask to be who I was, bro. Like, I didn't ask that. Nobody in here asked that. You feel me? Like, nobody did. The beautiful people. You feel me? Like, your beautiful parents made you, bro. You didn't ask for that. You feel me? Like, you didn't ask to live where you live or anything. It's like, that's, you feel me? So it's like, when you see people, forgive them and accept. You feel me? You got to open your mind and say, man, nobody asked to be born. Life is hard. Kinda. You know, life is hard, kinda. Hey, bro, I love you. I love you. Positively, you know. If we want to speak, look, and that's a good thing that you said that too, and I thank you for bringing that up. Because the thing, yeah, no, and I love you. How you doing, man? I want to say... I love all y'all, but I want to say, like, you know, with relationships and women and being together and everybody, man, you know, it's just like, you know, I mean, you know, it's just real. I'm just happy you guys are getting the real me. No pen, no pad. I didn't come here. I didn't come script the speech. You know, I didn't come, you know, come do some,
You know, this is, I come here, all I can do is be myself and spread love. You feel me? Like, every time, and I love you, you are too. And every time, but, you know, but with relationships and stuff, man, I'm just taking it slow, taking it easy right now. A lot of things are happening fast, man. A lot of things are happening real fast. But, you know, just taking my time and respecting, you know, respecting women, respecting others, and really, you know, yeah. I mean, but that's obvious, though, you know? To respect women and to respect others is obvious, you know? We should be, and a big thing, what I've been always thinking about, too, is why is the tone of, you see, like, the tone out here and with a lot of people, not out here, but I see, like, the tone with a lot of people I meet and just the media, I see, like, it's a lot of, if you get hit, you hit back. Why is that? And I respect that, you know, and I respect that. But at the end of the day, and I respect you for that, bro. And you know, I mean, I could have did it myself, but you know, real recognized, real bro, and it's like, you know, you get blessed out of situations. You see me? I did that situation because I wanted the world to see you can have a million stones thrown at you and you can still be positive. You know, that was kind of embarrassing. You know, I had a lot of hood credibility. You know, it kind of, I worked hard to get some of my imaginary hood respect. You know what I mean? But yeah, but you know, but at the end of the day, you know, it's no respect in being violent and a coward for no reason. You know, it's no honor in picking on people. It's no honor in senseless violence. It's no honor in war. You know, but, you know, at the end of the day, I look at it like this, too. When I look at, like, animals and I look at insects. Yeah. I'm the first rapper to adopt the tabby cat. Straight. Yeah. I adopted straight from the ASPCA, you feel me? We work up here too. I'm gonna be coming up over here in a second. But yeah, but you know. Just, you know, breaking the boundaries, man, and showing everybody, like, be yourself. It's okay to be yourself. I think that's the main thing. Embrace yourself. Embrace your health. Yeah. Oh! Hey! Hey, we'll talk about that soon. But you know, just embracing, you know, just continue to love yourself and accept, you know, because this image, I can't lie, like I when I was younger, I was a victim, not even a victim, but I loved the media. Like I, you know, believed everything the media, and as well as like my environment. I can say I was a product of my environment because I felt that I needed to have, like, when I was younger, man, it was crazy. Like, you know, you grow up and, like, you don't even, I remember, like, I didn't even know how to walk. Like, I was, like, so young. Like, and I was, like, wondering how I was walking. I was, like, in high school, I'm like, man, am I walking weird? I'm like, something's in my butt. I'm like, oh, I can't walk. You know, I'm like, man. You know what I mean? Like, really, really so conscious, though. like really so conscious and so hard on myself. You feel me? Like, hey, bro, so hard on myself. Like, you know, really just like, man, like, you know, and I say through time and like, you know, just through love, it's kind of just easing up on yourself, easing up on life. You know, it's a lot of words that people have given so much power. It's a lot of, you know, things that have kind of been going on, like, you know, or like I say, when I mean things, to me, to be specific, is, say, for instance, the tone of you hit me, I hit you. This has been a tone of, just like how I see with people, and it's like, that's not, you know, right. I don't want the new generation, how I see the generation, how I would love, why I, like, push what I do, and, like, how I hold my integrity, why I conduct myself in the way I do, why people see me and they say he didn't retaliate upon that man, and he could have. There's people that love me. There's people that was upset, you know? Back at the end of the day, man, and I love myself, back at the end of the day, you see, like, just because somebody wants to fight you for no reason, or, like, somebody, you know, says something, like, man, you can forgive that person. Like, you know what? Like, I'll be that guy's friend. You know? You gotta move on and be positive and cannot dwell. You know, it's we're way past dwelling. You know? And really just spread that love, man. So, you know, I keep with that. Like, you know, just keep that love and don't be so hard on yourself. You know, like, with anything, man. Like, you know, from how you look to weight, you know, to wanting to complete what your parents want you to be. You know, don't stress so hard. You know, like, you gotta pat yourself on the back. You guys are here at NYU. Congratulations. Congratulations. You know, what you guys are doing is something very brave. You know, everybody that's going through school, you guys have made a huge sacrifice to be here. All the staff, all the beautiful students, everybody that comes here to teach. Shouts out to everybody that's genuinely here to, you know, for learning and love and trying to find that way. I mean, shoot, we all trying to find our way, you know. Once again, this is my first very rare of history. I love y'all, you know. And like I said, well, I want to thank y'all. Thank you for embracing and accepting me. Like, really, really. I love you. You know, I want to show. Have friends of all creeds, all colors, all races. Stop saying black, white, this, that. We're human, you know. That's all those are to me. Now, I don't know everything. All this is my philosophy. You have a philosophy, and I respect everything. You feel me? I respect everybody. Now, I feel like things are just generalizations. Drop all that. Stop giving words so much, negative words so much power. You know, look at everybody. Instead of saying, hey, look at me, like, hey, he's black. Just say, like, hey, where are you from? Like, what is your nationality? Just take two more extra 20 seconds and say, hey, what's your nationality? Instead of generalizing and saying, hey, you're... Because I promise you, I looked up what black means online. And it's like, black means like something like coal or something. It's like, man, I don't look like coal, you feel me? Black man problems. Hey, bro. Hey, man, and we all got problems too, bro. Real talk. All of us, all y'all in here, we all got some problems, and we can all have something we can relate to. Everybody in here, make sure you can relate and have a comment, because it's nothing too different. Like, I, you know, it's not And if you do feel too different, you know, make sure you know you respect the people. You know, give people that extra chance. You know, give people a chance to come in your heart. I know why a lot of people don't trust a lot of people, because you know why? There's a lot of mean, bad people out here. You know, a lot of people are, they don't have a value on their own life. They don't have a value on what life means, how beautiful life is, how blessed we are to be alive. You know, how just, we are, our generation right here, all of us, right? We're on a class of earth together. Like, this is our generation. This is our class. Like, you know, this is us. Like, all of us, like, you know, and we're going to be our old generation. We're going to be like, hey, remember when, you know, when, you know, 20 years from now, you're like, man, remember when we did that? So don't be so hard on each other. Like, don't, you know, like, you know, let your friends have fun, man. Like, you guys should have fun, you know, and work hard and do what you got to do, because it's like, we only got one life to live. Yeah. Woo! And that, you know, and that is scary, you know? It's scary, and it's, you know, it's really real, you know? It's really true. And, like, with that, you know, it just makes me like, man, just appreciate people, man. Just appreciate every single person, like, main thing. Every single person you come in contact with, look at them like a golden $1 million baby. Say, like, man, just look, hey, bruh, if I'm gonna tell y'all the real secrets of life, bruh, I'm gonna tell you like this, bruh. Hey, bruh, everybody got the real secret, bruh. I'm gonna tell you like this, for real, bro. For real. Hey, real talk. The secret of life, one of the secrets, is if you look at everybody like they're a baby. Just look at everybody and say,
baby.
Remember me, like, you know, we just come like, you know, we're, you know, like, man, we're young, you know, like, man, don't be so hard on people, you feel me? Like, you know, we are, you know, like, man, we're just little baby insects or mammals or whatever, you know, or, you feel me? Like, I'm telling you, bro, I was looking at, you know, the insects, and I was, because I do my observations. When I go out, you know, I'm really, you know, I'm telling you, bro, look, if I don't become a neurosurgeon, or, like, if I don't, you know, I'm about to go into some bug, you know, I'm rocking. Y'all about to cuss again. But, you know, anyway, like, with the bugs, man, you know, you just be looking at them, and, like, because I was having these big ant problems in my, you know, my house, you know. And it was crazy because, like, at first, like, and these are people in their own way, too. As I was studying these ant colonies, you gotta, you know, and them infesting my house and daily, I can't even leave any food out, man. I left food at the top, something up here. Like, 20 minutes, like, I'm like, man, they already knew. In their bag. Hey, bro. In their bag. That's slang for we're having a big problem. You feel me? Hey. And real talk, like, you know, but seeing these ants and, you know, just studying them and respecting them, you know, it's like, man, like, you know, they're in their own community too. Like, these ants have their own community. They're trying to survive. They love. They fight. You know, I see them, like, caring. Like, you know, they're telling each other something. Regardless, we can't understand, and one day we will. I'm trying my hardest to figure out, you know, like, you know, just, you know, cause I'm there with them, you know, like, and we're very smart animals, you know, or whatever we are, organisms. What are we? What do y'all think we are?
Ants.
Yeah, mammals. Does anybody, is there like a fact?
Homo sapiens.
Does anybody have any proof where we are?
Evolutionary.
Hey, so all y'all better start coming up with your theories. You feel me? And we ain't got no proof, man. And look, live that life, experience, travel everywhere, and come up with your theories, man. And experience your life, man. And read the books too, like, you know, read everybody's theories. And experience your own, you know, like, and experience, you know, it's crazy, you know, some of the things I think about on the daily, man. I just really be wanting my people to be safe. Man, safety, you know, I be thinking about, like, safety. And real talk, man, everybody, make sure you wear seatbelts, for real. That'll save your life. Girls and family, hey man, I'm gonna tell you. And if I call you bruh, it's everybody. Like, hey, but hey, you know, it's friend, brother's friend. But you know, I'm like, man, like, care. I'm just like pro caring. I'm like, hey, wear your seatbelt. You know, I'm like telling everybody, like, man, make sure you feel me. And like, that's what we should. I feel like a big thing come, like a big thing we should bring back, like. Let's bring back caring about each other, like, honestly, genuinely. Like, I can look how I look, and everybody can have their preconceived notion about me. They can be like, I think he looks like this, and I have my vision in his head. But at the end of the day, break that down. Look at me, and I'm not what you think. You know, weird. And some people might not even be thinking nothing about me. They might just be having love, you feel me? They might just look at me like a baby, or whatever, like a love. Like a little alien.
Amen.
You know? People might look at me like a little alien, like a little... Exactly. Cuddle. Hold me. But, man, bro. And, like, real talk, man. Like, all this is a positive healing. With these... Like, with this historical time together, man, I want everybody to leave and just... in this building, know that everybody is your friend in here. You know, I pray that people came in. You know, I pray that people came in here, and we all, because I know that people that love Lil B music and respect Lil B's core from the truth, they know that, like, we're about positivity, about not judging, you know, letting people be themselves, about, you know, just embracing, like, positivity. Like, do you, man, be yourself 101,000%, you know? Amen.
You know?
So everybody, man, from the sides, you know, to the back, to the middle, to the sides up over there, like, man, I hope everybody can look at that person. Like, you might have know some, might not even know people, but I want everybody to know, like, because if you rock with Lil B music and you really respect me and know me from my core, you should know, like, that bass means that, you know, you have somebody that you can trust and you don't have to know them, because, you know, we all have a common courtesy. It's about having empathy now, you know, and what I mean by empathy is about really caring, like, and really, you know, paying attention to somebody else's feelings. You know what I mean? It's about really caring, man. Like, you gotta, you know, generally have some empathy for some people and really be like, man, we are all on this common vibe. It's peace. You know, the common vibe of peace is saying, hey, you know what? You can hit me, I'm not hitting you back. You know what I mean? And this is that takes a very big person to do that. And now you can do what you want to do. Now somebody attacks you and attacks your family, you know, protect what you got to do. Do what you got to do. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, too, I'm saying, if you really want to be a bigger person, I go to sleep, I'm so happy. You know why? Because I know, like, I'm living what I'm talking about. Like, I know I go to sleep at day, I'm like, man. On my big bag, on my big, big, you know, I'm just like, man. I'm history. I'm like, I'm making history, and I'm living it, and I'm honest, and I'm honest. Man, it feels so good to be honest. You know, and honest as we can be, you feel me? Yeah. Honesty. honesty, integrity, loyalty, passion, friendship. Hey, for real, man, and that's real, like, you know, I'm telling you, like, and it's funny, you feel me, like, I know a lot of people are like, man, it's funny, but this is how I really feel, and I'm glad, like, I can come and tell you guys can meet me personally and see my personality and say, you know, this is Lil B, this is what he really wants, you know, regardless of what anybody can say, regardless of anybody, I want everybody in here to live as long as possible, have a great, healthy as possible life, you know, fun, full of adventure, full of mystery, you know.
Thank you,
I love you, bro. I love you. Thank y'all. And full of trials and tribulations. You know, trials and tribulations. Yeah. Hey, and you know, that trials and tribulations, man, and just going through and seeing things, man, and like, you know, and being able to forgive. I want a lot of you guys, test your friends. See which one of your friends really loves you. You know, see who really loves you. Remember that. Like, test your friends. See who's going to be with you forever. You know, see, you know, just see. Sometimes, you know, take some time out for yourself and, you know, see, like, you know, are my friends, you know, and with time, a lot of people miss, you know, communication and messages is such a deep thing, and friendships, and people have so many things that they tangle the friendship. They're like, well, I knew this person since I grew up, but this person's a douche. You feel me? But it's like, so I'm gonna still be his friend. But it's like, we don't agree. But it's like, because I have some weird thing in my head, I'm going to still be your friend. But it's like, nah, man. Like, day by day. And you know, just be honest with yourself. Be like, man, like, be around people who are, you know, represent you. Or, like, who you feel like, you know, who you feel is on the same kind of monotone. You feel me? Like, who's on your wavelength? You feel me? And I love y'all, and it's like, hopefully, everybody in this building, we're all on the same wavelength, you feel me? And I know we are, you know, in ways, you know what I mean? And we are in ways because, like, you guys are very brave and historical and legendary, like I said, for just giving and being here with me and seeing, like, so I know right here, everybody is on the wavelength, because I'm looking at everybody and I know, like, man, I could come hang out, come chill, man. We're gonna have some good stories. What are some of the things that y'all be feeling? You know, what are some of the things that you guys are going through? You know, what's going on in your head right now? That's that million. I'm feeling like Michael Jackson out there. He ripped the wrist like, you know what it is, start hitting that. I'll do that. I'm too subtle right now. You see what we got right now, man. We represent right now. Got the beautiful quilt here. You know. I would have came up here in a suit so y'all could take me serious. But
take you serious,
based on
always.
I love y'all, man. And I take y'all so seriously too. I take the bass guy very seriously too. Like, that's history right there in itself, man. It's crazy. But, you know, like I say, man, this isn't about me. This is about y'all and me spreading my love to y'all. That's all I want for this is, like, it's about saying how much I love you guys. You know, how much I love being alive. how much I love human beings, how lucky we are to have this structure. Who built this? Tell me who built this building, please. But you know, like real talk, man, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, just going through New York, man, you just see like, wow, how much beautiful, like, architecture, man. You guys have so much, like, just like so much, you know, it's so rich and hip. You know, like, when I look at the buildings, man, I'm like, dude, this is, you know. You guys are lucky. Everybody's lucky because this might not be here forever. This building, anything can happen. You know, I pray, you know, but like, really be happy. Take heed. You guys are lucky. You're alive. You're lucky. Hey, take heed. No, really take heed. Can I hear you say, I'm lucky, I'm alive.
Lucky, I'm alive.
No, please, can you really say to feel it? I'm lucky, I'm alive.
I'm lucky, I'm alive.
Real tough. Yeah, man, yeah. Hey, man. Man, nah, but real talk. Let your body, like, don't ever deny the voices in your head either. When you're sitting by, listen, when you're sitting at home alone, right? We all went through depression, anxiety, you know, things like everything, man. And when you're sitting at home and you're by yourself and you hear those voices going wild in your head, or you're unconscious, or you're your angels on your side, or your mental, or, you know, your gut feeling or your heart, you feel me? Like, let those voices, listen to them, and let your mind tell you what you feel. Let your body tell you, you know, be in tune with your rare, like, this is a very rare thing. I'm like a robot, you know what I mean? I'm like... Hey, look, tell your hand to do this. It's like, man. I mean, that's not amazing? Hey, bro. Hey, bro. That's amazing to me. That's amazing to me, man. I tell you, man, like, you know, and salute to all the beautiful doctors, everybody that's actually researching and helping us, you know, like, find new things, find cures. Salute to everybody that's finding cures for diseases. You know, everybody that's aiding to the people. You know, thank you to everybody that all these hard workers do. To everybody in here that aids to the people. Everybody that's in here, the silent, beautiful American people that go unheard, but that are working hard daily.
You know, big bucks, baby.
Hey, thank you, like, to the staff, everybody. You know, a lot of people, man, because it's like, honestly, a lot of people deserve to be where I'm at right here. You feel me? Everybody, you know, it's a lot of people that's legendary, you know. So for those, you know, people that will be and, you know, that aren't here, you know, I love you. And it's like, man, you know, and like, we all, man. I don't know, man. You know, but you know, I have nothing to hide neither. So it's like, hey, man, you know, I might run for president because it's like, hey, y'all know everything about me. Hey, and it's like, hey, bro, hey.
Thanks, God, for president.
My very smart NYU family, I tell you, I have nothing to hide, and y'all shouldn't either. You know, like, don't let people's stereotypes or stigmas or words, you know, don't let that, you know, put you in a box, or like, don't let that run your day. Don't be depressed anymore. You know, be happy. You know, but believe in yourself. We all got to do that too. Like, we all go through times where we're like, you sit there and you look at yourself in your mirror, you're like, ew. Really? I mean, I went to the mirror, man, a while ago. I'm like, damn, man. I'm like, how? Exactly. Not even pretty. I'm like, how am I succeeded, you know what I mean? I'm like, man. I look at the mirror, I'm like, man, you know. Thank you. No, thank you. And I love y'all. Y'all make me feel gorgeous. But you know, sometimes just as a human, you go to the mirror and you're like, oh my God. I'm not that gorgeous right now. You're like, man, you know. But it's all from your heart, though. And that's why you always will feel gorgeous 100%. Because to say I'm not that gorgeous is only a reflection on the media. So at the end of the day, you know, I am very gorgeous. Because gorgeous is whatever you are. Like, you are gorgeous. I tell you. You are what you believe you are. You know what I mean? Right. You are a model, you know what I mean? You are a rapper, you are a legend, you are a student, you are a positive person. Like, you know, do not let these words feel like you guys are different or we're different and like separate each other. Like, nobody's different, I'm telling you, like, and nobody asked to be born.
Amen.
I'm telling you, bro. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. What's up? What? I mean, you know, Cray was going on. Cray, you know, Cray was slang. Like, that was slang in the barrier, you know. Shouts out to Jay-Z, though, bro. Shouts out to Jay-Z. You feel me? Yeah, shouts out. But, you know, hey man, does anybody else, you know, ever have anything that they really just want to, like, ask me, or, you know? I think, like, look, and look, I say it like this, out of respect, and this is the big thing too, right? So look, you see everybody raising their hand, right? Because look, I see somebody go, just me personally, like, when I see somebody driving, my whole attitude of respect is, let this person go. Like, that's my first initial reaction. Like, I'm like, you see somebody raise their hand, here you go. You know what I mean? It's like, and that's why, so just that vibe, you know, I'm just setting that tone. So it's like, okay, we all got our hands ready. Everybody want to talk. So it's like, let the person talk and you'll be next. You feel me? So it's like, I think everybody can do a civilized. And that's just setting the tone. I'm just wanting people to see, this is the tone, like, of respect that I'm carrying. You know what I mean? And like the love of people, like the admiration and just like of the respect that I'm trying to instill for the generations now and the generations. You know, I'm not here, like, I don't have no secret plan behind me. Like, I'm not, like, some secret whatever, you feel me? Or, like, I'm, you know, nothing. I genuinely want to bring back the people, you feel me? Like, get us all loving each other. And, like, really saying, like, man, nobody's, like, we all on the same level. You know, we all human, we all people. Have fun while you're alive. I'm telling you, have fun while you're alive. I promise you. Hey, bro, because any, like, I'm telling you, is God bless, like, I'm telling you, because we're all about to die somewhere, remember that. And it's going to be ready. But, you know, I just want to say, like, you know, and humbly think about this, you know, our bodies are amazing, you know, we're all consistently, you know, our white warrior blood cells and the red blood cells and everybody's like fighting for us in our body and we don't see. So salute to our brain and our cells just fighting for us. Fighting off those infections when you rub your butt and you forget to, you know, when you write a paper and you scratch your butt and then you go shake your partner hand. Wash your hands. I'm washing my hands all the time. Shouts out to Sam for that. I see. Yeah. Hey. Hey, even if you didn't, I would still shook it. You know, because, you know, at the end of the day, we cannot judge anybody from the homeless to the richest, whatever that means, to the, you know, dog to the cat, you know, it's like, you have to look at these things. I thank my car that I didn't get to an accident. I'm like, oh my God. I'm like, thank you, brand new Duncan and I drive under 50,000, so anything I drive, I got no more than 50,000, man. Straight from Europe. Hey, bro. And I'm telling you, I'm Buick, Doug, Toyota, whatever. Like, man, the comment, you know, we doing it. But like I said, I thank my car. I'm like, thank you, whoever, whatever, earth, spirit, myself, people. I'm like, I got to point A to point B safely. Congratulations to everybody getting here safely, man. I'm telling you. You know, 5-0. And shouts out to New York for always embracing me. You know, for real, man. Always. Because, like, man, we are so much, like, it's crazy. Like, you know, to coming from, you know, everybody from Berkeley. You know. And coming and being in this industry, and you guys gotta watch out. Watch out in business, there are gonna be a lot of people. You know what? And this is crazy, and I'm gonna tell you like this, and this is what I really live by, and I'm happy, like, I run my business by this. You see a lot of people, they're like, oh, and I cannot stand these kind of people. You feel me? I promise you. But look, it's like this though. You know, they're like, ah, man, it's just business. You know, business is business. It's like, you know, it is business. It's like, man, what are you talking? Have some people love, like, what happened to humans? Everybody's thinking about capital gain. Hey, bro, I'm serious though. Like, you, like, man, like, you know, like, I'm like, dude, like, I'm hollering at somebody. I'm like, you know, I do this for the love. Like, I've been doing this for the love, bro. You feel me? Like, it's for the love. Like, I do this for the free, you know, for the love. Y'all make me, the people make me. You feel me? Y'all been making me. I've been giving you stuff free. Over 2,000 songs. History. You know, but you see, like, people, you know, you see people, they're like, oh, it's a business, like, this is just business, this is how it goes. It's like, well, you know what, I'm gonna run my business different. I'm gonna be running my, like, you know, you don't have to be, it's like, all right, you know, it is for business, but do what you love to do, you feel me? Like, if you want to do something out of the love and the spirit, do something because your heart tells you that. Do something, not for, oh, because it's the business, oh, to be mean to them because it's the business, or, you know, I'm gonna do this favor because it's the business, or I'm gonna not pay attention to you because it's the business, or, you know, I'm gonna treat you unequal because it's the business, or I'm gonna make up a bunch of things because it's the business. What happened to just being like, I'm a naked human being? I just, you know what I mean? It's like, even though we're not, we're advanced now, like you see. I mean, it's obvious we're not naked. I look at this stuff, I'm like, man, salute to the architects, man. Everybody that's designing anything. Hey, we got anybody in here for designing? Anybody designing anything or anything? Hey, bro, salute to you, bro. That's real octane, man. Like, salute to you. Build some of the next beautiful buildings, family. Thank you, man. Thank you, you know? Right. So what's everybody doing up in here? Like, what you going here for? Like, I know we got a lot of future legends in the building. What's everybody, you know? What's everybody? Congratulations. Hey, man, salute yourself. Like, man, talk about yourself. Be happy, man. Boss, like, what you in here for?
Start a record studio.
I have a question!
What you going here for, bro? That's what's up. What about you, bro? That's a little salute, bro. Salute. Congratulations. Anybody else want to say what they're going here for? Salute, Hey, well, you, hey, well, you know, I'm taught this is one of the best schools ever. So, man. Man. Hey, salute to the generation, man, and all our kids that are just going to be friends. You know, I can't wait for, like, all of our kids because we're so happy. Like, we're all, like, it's great because I'm telling you, we're about to grow up, like, 50, 40, and we're going to be looking at people with no boundaries, no colors, no judgment. Like, I want, like, my, you know, my thing, and I'm going to really do this, you know. I'm going to have a place where, like, you can come. It's going to be like a city, and, you know, you can come, and it's going to be like, bro. Everybody is on the same wavelength of positivity, you know. Let, like, you know, you see somebody, let them go, you know. Ask somebody, how are you doing today? I had to train myself for that. It wasn't something, like, I didn't just become a happy person. You feel me? I had to train myself. I lied to myself for a while at first. No, because I had to train myself because it was like, I had to, like, because I wasn't always positive because, like, when I was younger, I think I was so busy in trying, like being cool and, you know, just really being cool. I think, like, that was my biggest thing, like, being, like, younger and having, like, I had my, like, I was skinny and stuff. I'm like, damn, you know, I need to garner my respect somehow in the streets. You know, I was like, man, I didn't want to get picked on, you know. And so it was things that I did that I felt were necessary. And when you grow up, you're like, I was so stupid. Like, not even stupid, but you're just like, man, I was so... Exactly, like, you know, I was just so wrapped up in, you know, be yourself. Like, I was just so wrapped up in, like, man, you know, friends and wanting to be this and wanting respect and wanting all, you know, and it's like, man. Yeah, this was young, man. This was young and I felt, you know, and I was just looking at, you know, it's crazy, like, what goes on, like, you know. Like, just saying, like, just everybody, how, like, you, everybody, like, you see, like, the cool guys, like, you see, or, like, you know, in high school, there's, like, the bad guys and the bad kids, and it's, like, some wild, like, or everybody, like, everybody, and everybody has their niche or whatever, like, whatever it is, and, you know, it is just, like, you know, I was a product of the media in my environment. Like, I seen the people that I like, I seen the gold teeth. I was like, man, I want gold teeth because the guy on TV, he looked like me with gold teeth. You feel me? So I'm like, I like gold teeth. I'm like, this dude looks like me with the grill. You feel me? And, like, everybody can get grill in here. You feel me? Like, everybody should embrace, like, get gold teeth. Don't be, look, I'm just saying, like, don't be thinking so hard. Like, oh my God, I can't get gold teeth. It's like, what are you talking about? Like, what? Who's gonna say what to you? Who's gonna say what to you? Because we got love in our heart. You're good people. We're good people. What you, like, what's people gonna say? Like, can't nobody tell you nothing if you're doing it from the love and you're embracing people. You feel me? Like, have fun, man. Like, you know, do that, man. And, like, try to be less ignorant as possible. That's what I try to do. I try to be less ignorant as possible. And, like, And meet people. I say, what I'm trying to do is set a tone of class for the younger generations, you know, so they'll come. You can look how you want, you know, you can look how you want, however, but you are now going to be judged from your soul and your heart, you know, and how you feel, you know, and that's what I want, you know, what I work every day. And why I love you guys so much, and thank you for being able to tell you this, is, like, you know, I want people to no longer, as hard as it is, to not judge somebody from the look. But, you know, I want everybody to now not judge anybody from how they look, but from their heart and their actions and their positivity and how much they put out there. Because even if you, like, man, even if you pissed off, still say stay positive. Even if you, like, you know, even if you got a friend doing bad and, you know, you, like, and you don't feel that way, you, like, stay positive. You know, you're like, man, stay positive, dude. Like, whatever. You know, because that's, like, man, that's the only way positivity, happiness, forgiving.
Amen. Amen.
Forgiving. I think that's number one. Forgive. forgive and say, man, like, we only human. Like, real talk, man. Like, hey, man, nobody hates you. Nobody hates you. You know, nobody hates you. Like, you know, real, we might feel like somebody hates us or like, you know, and people do, you know, people do mean things. I deal with this every day, you know. And that's why I feel like I got this confidence and it's real about me, and I go to sleep every night and I feel really good because, you know, like, you see there every day, constant, you know, hate, like, you know, threats, you know, everything. And you sit back and you just like, man, you take that deep breath. And you like, man, the people that really love me, and like, you know what you do it for. You know, we all are searching life to find out how are we going to serve humanity. What are we going to do that we can do for free for the rest of our life that, you know, that we feel good about? What is your way that you're going to serve humanity? You know what I mean? How are you going to serve the humans? You know how I serve the humans? Coming here doing this. You know how I serve humanity? Serving humanity is spreading true love. Putting myself out there to be vulnerable, to be criticized, to be one of the most critique artists ever. You know what I mean? To, you know, just really just on a, you know, I'm like on a, you know, they're like, they're like, Little B said this at this time. Technically, Little B's talking here. You know what I mean? Like, and you know, it's beautiful. And I want to give this scarf to somebody too. And real talk. And I wanna make sure I give some books to like some of the beautiful students that made this happen. You know, I got a few of my rare books. And Seth, you bring me out one of your books, huh? But like, you know, yeah, thank you, yeah, take it over. It's love, bro, love. And shouts out to Seth, bro. I see you. Shouts out to Dear Passwords. But, you know, I want to say, you know, this is the first book I ever wrote when I was 19, man. It's called... We got the positive, I love you, man. We got the positive DVD in there. So I want y'all to really... Because y'all see me right now. So regardless, you know... So you already know me because you see me right now. So you guys know my true core. Like, it's no like... sketchy or like he's doing this to like fraud or he has some corporate company backing him or you know like I'm doing something. It's like, no, I really love people. I'm really here for the people. It's no gimmicks. I don't care. I don't, you know, I do this. I pick and choose what I want to do. I deny a lot of people. I love it and I will stay rare. Nobody will ever work with Lil B. That's how it goes. Hey. And you know what? You can do that when you got a lot of love. When you love people so hard, and you put yourself out there for the people, like, I'm ready to die for the humans. I'm ready to die for positivity. I'm ready to be the poster. You know, it's funny because I see a lot of hip-hop artists, and they don't understand the position that they're in, or the artist. They say, I'm not a role model. They be like, Blood, I'm not a role model. They like, Blood, I ain't a role model. I feel totally different. I feel like I am a role model. I feel like we all are. You know, we all are role models. And I feel like, you know, like I said, without y'all, it would be no me. But like, I feel like, you know, as a role model in, cause with influence, this is a big thing, the power of influence. I think that's, we all have that. You know, if you have Twitter followers or you have friends, you know, anybody, you know, the power of influence is big and you always want to use your powers and spirits and positivity for the right thing. Please put down the guns. Put down the gun violence. You know, the knife violence. The chemical warfare, let's stop that. The biological warfare, let's stop that. Let's stop fracking. Who knows about hydraulic fracking? Hey, Brian. Hey, Brian. Hey, Brian. Stop messing with the earth, Brian. Yeah, no, real talk. We hear about these things, these deadly gases that are going on with the earth, man, and everything. You know, I'm like, whoa, dude, for real. I'm like, whoa, dude. I'm like, whoa, dude, get that oil out the ocean, whoa, dude. But, like, at the end of the day, like, I see, like, this, like, what we're living in. We were all born into something. Like, you gotta salute the humans before us, right? Like, at the end of the day, I have no problem and no animosity with no, like, because we're in a beautiful place where today. This is a beautiful place. It's imperfections, it's like a dub, nothing's perfect, but this is beautiful right now. Like, this is beautiful right now at this moment. And, like, you know, we gotta be happy about something. You know, we gotta be happy about something, and everything's not gonna be right. You know, we got to be happy about something right now. And, you know, it's just continuous, like, you know, continuous life living, man. Continuous life living. Continuous rotations of life living. But, you know, like I said, stop messing with this earth. You know, I'm going to be really going in and learning a lot more just about ways to protect. I mean, like, trust me, I don't even litter. Like, I'm not even littering. Like, you see me? Like, I'm not throwing trash on the ground because I think, if I throw this trash right here, I'm like, man, like, this is just, like, adding to somebody who is gonna pick it up or, like, might not wanna pick it up or, like, this is some animal that's gonna be trapped in it. You know what I mean? Or, like, you know, something, you know, you just like, man, at the end of the day, it's just us gotta take, it all starts from you, you feel me? Like, regardless, it's like, I had to take steps myself for people to believe in me and believe me. I had to be a walking light of spiritual positivity and, like, a walking beam of love before anybody could respect that and be like, you feel me? Like, you know, it's a big thing, like, people call me the base guy out of respect. This is not out of, like, a lot of people. No, people are stupid. Everybody in here has a high class of honor. And it's crazy when the highest class of honor, people call me the base guy, because the base guy came from positivity, from love, you know, from watching out for people. So it's like, man, I take that with heed, you know, and, like, when people say, you know, you are the base guy, you know, and I accepted that. And I am not the base guy, because the base guy's better than me, you know what I mean? But, like, it's crazy, you know, it's crazy, you know, it's crazy. It's crazy. But, you know, like, we all got a hand in love, man, and we all, one by one, just one of us, each and every one of us is, like, you know, we just got to continue to live and kind of embed, you know, just continuously embed that positivity, like, hey, look at that person. Like, hey, this person didn't ask to be born. They didn't ask to be who they are. And it's like, man, embrace their style. Like, look at somebody and be like, man, they're unique. You know, not they're different. But look at them and be like, man, this is how are we similar? You know, you got to start looking at people and be like, so how are we similar? You know what I mean? Like, what is our commons? But enough about me. You know what I mean? Because, like I said, this is about, like, y'all. And I want to figure out what you guys feel. And at the end of the day, too, like, with me, too, it's like, man, you know, like, my grammar, spelling, and how I say things might not be technically, you know, what we hear, or, like, textbook, or, you know, like, anything. But at the end of the day, as long as you can understand me, as people, you feel me? As long as you have to work as a human with empathy and love in your heart and staying based and staying positive or staying normal, staying right, you have to make an effort. You have to make an effort to learn about people. It's just like, you know, you gotta make an effort at your job. It's just with people. You gotta make an effort to care. And it's it takes a lot out of me. That's why I can't talk to everybody, because I care about everybody genuinely. like genuinely. And so, you know, when you do that, when you care about everybody, when you look at everybody like they're $1 million, it takes a lot of energy out of you, because you're not just gonna be like, hey, I'm gonna disrespect you, or I'm not gonna listen to you. You know, you give everybody a chance, and this is the successful lifestyle and the successful attitude of personal excellence. Success is what people see on the outside, but I live a life of personal excellence, and that's for myself. Personal excellence, how I feel about it, is just, you know, excellence. People can look at, you know, success and look at a Bentley as success, or, you know, look at money as success, or however people monetize or, like, you know, put success in a box. You know, and it's said like what it is, but you know, at the end of the day, you know, personal excellence is what we strive for. You know what I mean? Because that's in yourself. You know, to keep yourself happy. You know, love. Because everybody's successful. All y'all in college, y'all make it. So I mean, we all successful. Like everybody in here is successful. So you can, everybody be like, what are you talking about? Leave me alone. You know what I mean? Like everybody's successful. Everybody can, you know. But now it's about that personal excellence, like going back. You know, and I have no pride. Like, I have no pride issues. You feel me? Like, I have no pride. I, you know, so I can be under as well as be on top. And that's for the people. You know, we gotta be here. You know, that's why I've never signed a deal. I'm unsigned. You know, I have no record label behind me. When you see everything I do, this is me, you know, this is me 100% by myself, like pushing my love, you know. A lot of, you know, it was a lot of managers and fake managers that really wanted to manage me and claim that they did, and a lot of things. You gotta watch out for the industry predators. There are, and just predators in business. There are a lot of people, sexual predators, we deal with that, you know, and that's a very touchy subject, and it's a very, you know, it's very comfortable for all of us. And I want to tell y'all, you know, and I love y'all. Anybody that has went through hardships like that or anything, you know, forgive. Forgive. And that's the best thing I can tell you, is forgive and cleanse your soul. You know, and forgive yourself. You feel me? Like, I'm telling you, man, don't be hard on yourself. And, you know, like I said, I love it because I don't write my speeches. Like, anytime I, you know, do this, anytime I'm going to speak, you know, it's going to be from the heart, and it's going to be brand new, you know, every day. Because, like, you can't write love. You can't write down love. Like, if I was a phony man, like, y'all could look me in my face, man. If I didn't love y'all, you feel me, and I didn't have love, and I didn't really care about the community and the people and wanting people to excel. I want all of us as a human race to excel and stop being so hard on each other. Stop using these things as separation. Stop using words. Stop saying, why are you dressed like that? What are you talking about? Like, stop, you know, like, stop thinking so hard about things. Like, stop, somebody looks different from you. Stop, like, admire them, stare at them, and have a light heart. Get light-hearted. I think that's a big tone of, what, you know, I pray everybody in the building in our APG and what I said in the book, the Anything Is Possible generation. And, you know, really, like, man, I just want all of us to, you know, be able to just, you know, be you, you know, the Anything Possible generation, you know, base, you know, keep it base. You know, what do I mean by base? What does base mean?
Positive.
It's like God. It's like I can't get away from it. It's like, hey man, what's up, family? Really with me, and you know, I'm 100% still in the pack. But you know, really, you know, I mean, we coming. You know, we coming, man. Shouts out, Young L, Stunner Man, Lil Uno. You know, we coming. You know, we coming. You know, we coming. Nah, we coming. But you know, really with me, though, just making history, man. Like, I couldn't, the people really wanted me. Like, the supporters and the people made me, you know, you guys, like, everybody. So that was really my only reason. Like I say, man, I've been giving you guys free stuff. Like, you don't have to listen to me. You don't have to watch me. Like, you know, I'm not on TV every day. I'm about to be. But you know, right now, I'm not on TV every day. You know, you guys are the beautiful people. You guys are the so beautiful people that really are accepting me. And this is, like, great. You know, my mom would be happy. I thank you guys, because it's like, man, you guys are really making me a special person. And I really appreciate that. Like, you know, you guys have made me special. And for return, you will always give my genuine love and consideration. I'm not perfect. I get mad sometimes. I deal with people that threaten me. I have to protect myself. You feel me? Like, I gotta do it. I gotta protect Lil B. Everybody know, protect Lil B. Protect your family.
Protect Lil B.
Protect the base guy. Hey, bro. Because it's only one of me, and I promise you, there's nobody ever in rap, or nobody's done what I've done first in the rap history. You know, first thing for being the first artist ever, the bass guy, as well as me being the first artist ever to release an ambient hip hop album in history with no cursing, right in England. You know, so I am about to be releasing, you know, I love you. Love is strange, and that is real, you know. Love is strange. You know, it was great. You know, it was an honor working with Wayne and being like him. Yeah, me and him was in the studio together. And
a question, man.
I was really nervous at that time. I wrote an iSearch project. And yes sir. And I have heard you. And I definitely hear you. Can I answer? Can I continue? Can I finish? Or do you? Okay. And, you know. No. It was just me being considerate. You know, me being considerate, you know. You want to ask people, you know, he's a man, you know, I have to ask him, hey, you know, like, I hear you too. And, but, like, you know, it was crazy working with Wayne, man, and just being in the studio. Like, shouts out to Mac Main. And, yeah, bro, shouts out to Birdman too. You know, Birdman. Hey, no, yeah, shouts out to Birdman on the real, bro. Hey, bro. Hey, but, you know, like, working with Wayne, bro, was just a... You know, to see how much love he had for me, and to like him to know how much I love him, and for him to already embrace like family, like Wayne family, and it's good. Like, that ain't the last track we about to do. Like, we got something in store, and you guys are going to freak out because, like, real talk, I got a song with one of the biggest artists, pretty much the biggest artist on earth. So, you know, you will see, and it's. Thank you. And whew, yeah, we coming. But you know, I'm gonna let you guys know some history with me towards the end. But like, anything else that you got? What was the question? Yeah, bro.
Me?
Yep.
I wanna know who likes to paint.
Who I like to paint?
Yes.
You know, I definitely do, man. My mom was a big painter, and I haven't been painting. Hey, bro. Hey, family. But you know what I do rock with? My favorite is watercolors. I'm a watercolors type of dude, man. So, you know, definitely collect some of my rare paintings. I'm going to, you know, do some. But... Go ahead, family. What's up?
What's your next step?
Actually, well, you guys are the first to hear my next step. I'm actually releasing my rock album. I'm actually coming out with a rock album. Regardless, you know, me selling platinum records and, like, you know, me going gold or anything like that, I already made history in rap. You know, like, nobody's ever done what I've done. So with that, like, I'm actually, you know, out of respect, you know, for people. You know, I'm not just some joke, you know, like some fluke, you know, hey, some hip-hop guy's gonna make some joke rock album. No, this is gonna be real respect. This is gonna be some garage punk. This is gonna be for the rebels. This is gonna be a real... Not even off no real punk, like, the women, like, you know, the women and the ladies, you know, we about to be having a real good time with my fellas. But, you know, look out for the Lil B Rock album, California Boy! We got a history in NYU, because y'all the first person to ever hear that. Lil B Rock album! I'm shutting it down. It's about to be a celebration for all of us. Thank you guys for believing in me. Because this rock album is about to go down in history. On everything. You know, on everything.
What? I see that.
Yo, what's up, Phil?
What do you want to say to my mom? Because my mom was in my room listening to Rain in England on my record player, and she heard the lyrics about women with gray hair being beautiful, and she started crying. She was like,
I love you. Thank you, family. Respect knowledge. If you see somebody with gray hair, embrace that beauty. Show the world that we are beautiful.
Amen. That was me, like, trying to get everybody to rally. And that was, like, weak. Now,
show the world we're beautiful.
I'm out here trying to get my Mitt Romney on. Show them. Hey, here you go. Show the world we're beautiful. Hey, I better not talk about Mitt, bro. You might not see me. You might. Hey, he's like, what happened to Lil B? Lil B's in jail. Why is he in jail? It's like,
protect
Lil B. By the government. It's like Lil B made jokes about Mitt Romney at NYU, and he's in prison for some reason now. It's like, why?
Where can you get your beautiful jewelry from?
Yo, what's up, man? Oh, well, no. What was you saying, though, about continuing, like, or was that you just wanted to tell me that?
I just wanted to tell you that.
I love you.
To let you know how much you inspired, or
if you have anything to say. Well, thank you, man. I want to, you know, first appreciate her and appreciate you, and thank you so much for listening to that. And, you know, I just want to tell her I love her. And, you know, congratulations. Like, congratulations for her making it so long on Earth, and I pray that she... No, listen, what? Serious. Congratulations to her, and I pray that she stays alive longer, bro, because we all aren't going to have our parents forever. So I love her, and I love you, and I'm happy that you got her right now. Go ahead.
Where do you get your awesome jewelry? The jewelry, right?
Right.
Are you going to have your own clothing line?
You know, I'm not trying to, I've never been here to capitalize off people. You know, a lot of people, I only really do what I really love and, like, what I really, you know, because, like I said, I got full control of it. So it's like, I'm not here, like, you know, I know a lot of people want to buy stuff from me, and a lot of people are buying other clothing lines, think that they're me. I have no clothing line now, so anybody that you're buying, you're supporting them. And that's good. You know, support humans. I put out money, I spend my money in America because this is our money. And I pay taxes, I'm about to pay taxes. I'm happy because of that. I'm happy because of that. I don't know what it's going for, but I pray that it's going for the people. I'm happy because of that. Regardless, like, the government says it, so I'm gonna give them the benefit of the doubt.
Yo,
Hey, but look, if anybody's smart got some facts, let me know. Let me know. If y'all got some other, you think like, man, don't rock with the government. But until further notice, I'm paying taxes and I'm loving it, you know? And I'm keeping that money forth because you gotta spend money. You can't just hold that money. Like, you can't just hold money and that's not how you keep people alive. And, you know, you gotta buy people dinner. You gotta buy people, you know. Never deny your friends food. Out of anything, if your friends are hungry, at least give them food.
Amen.
Go ahead. Yep. What's up, man?
You're an inspiration. What inspires you?
You guys, and thank you. You know, you guys, you see, we're talking every day. You know, and a lot of people hit me up, but you, bruh, you being here with me, man, and you know, you can be my brother. You know, we brothers now. You know, we brothers, bruh. And it's good. You know, it's good. You know, regardless, like, and everybody speak both languages, too. You know, listen to slang. Go listen to, like, you know, quote, because it's like when you hear, when slang is like learning another language, be bilingual and go learn some slang.
Hello.
Cheesy.
Oh, mamas.
Nah, and I'm gonna tell you some real slang. I'm gonna tell y'all some real, real slang. You feel me? Hey, brain, nah. Everybody got his slang, and you know some things. Just rep that.
I'm mamas.
You feel me?
Out of pocket.
You feel me?
I feel you.
Yeah, bro. But you know, swag. Yeah, dummy. Coolie Key, man, is me. It's having fun. You know, Coolie Key is just like Coolie Key. You're in the air, baby. I'm telling you, live it.
God.
Yeah, oh yeah, man. J-Lec family, you know, we got some popping. We're going to be doing that. Shouts out to J-Electronic, you know. Yeah. You know, that's a very, very, like, that's one of the only people, like, in rap I'm listening to. Because a lot of people aren't original, you know. A lot of people aren't original. Like, shouts out to my bro Drake, you know, he got the love. My brother Drake, and I love him. Like, you know, everybody is rapping like him. You know, and he's the man for that. Like, you know, it's like, bro, like, and I respect artists. You know, you gotta be yourself, you feel me? Like, let my brother Drake have his swag, you feel me? Like, exactly, like, let Lil B have his swag.
What's that
point?
He owns
you know,
swag.
Basecott, we're from rapgenius.com. I love your brain.
Thank you, man. I love you too.
Explain your lyrics.
I love you.
You are the Gandhi of hip hop. We got Nas explaining his own lyrics. We got RZA. We need Lil B the Basecott on Rap Genius.
Hell yeah.
Verified
account. I got you.
Fuck with me, man. We love you.
Love you too.
Let me take this Rap Genius t-shirt. I love you, man.
Shout out to Rap Genius, man. And I would love, if anybody ever has any questions about my lyrics, I would love to spit a cappella and, you know, word for word.
Praise God!
If you need to decode my lyrics, like if you ever had questions, like, okay, what are you saying here? What does that mean? We'll see what's up with the lyrics after that, but anybody got questions still?
Can I bust
tonight? Sir? Oh, man, please. I mean, how... Man, congratulations, man. You know, and that's salute to the family. I stand by that, man. That's my brother right there. His hand is gold.
What's up, bro?
Yeah, man, you already know, man. I appreciate that. I love you for that, fam. Alright, y'all, so look, we about to have to wrap up, right? And we got to shut the scene down, but I want to take pictures with y'all from Facebook and Twitter. So, we got to take these rare pictures real fast and we're going to get up out of here. I want to give some books to y'all, too, so.
Oh,
I love you!
Woo! Wait, 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 wait,